We've all heard the saying, space is the final frontier, but what does that mean? At this point in history, only two human beings have ever set foot on another planet, and those were both astronauts on board Apollo missions. Which means we're still in the very early days of exploring our solar system. Many people believe that we'll never be able to live off Earth because of how incredibly expensive it would be. But as space exploration advances over time, it's possible that colonizing other planets will become less expensive and more feasible. We've already sent rockets into space, so why not send humans too? So let's talk about space colonization. Is it possible or just a dream? Why space colonization? One of the greatest challenges in our society is exploring and colonizing new frontiers. It's no wonder that people are fascinated by space colonization. With each passing day, we get closer to living on other planets and moons orbiting around other stars. The need for it has never been greater than it is today because humans are overpopulating Earth and causing irreparable damage through pollution and climate change. Despite all these concerns about the planet we call home right now, there are many who believe that humanity should be looking beyond our own world for a better future instead of trying to save it from its own destruction at home. Space colonization could give us plenty of benefits. We could combine all three dimensions, length, width, and height, into one large physical space where people can live anywhere they want without having any limits imposed upon them by gravity or weather conditions as they do on Earth today. Mars is not the best planet for space colonization. It has a thin atmosphere and low gravity, which means that people won't be able to breathe easily there. Plus, the low gravity will make it hard to move around without assistance. Mars experiences dust storms that could be dangerous to humans. The longer they're exposed to them, the more likely they are to get radiation poisoning or lung damage from inhaling too much sand dust particles into their lungs. There is little water on Mars, so if there was ever any kind of leak in your spaceship or habitat pod, then everything would be ruined right away. This is because there would be no protection from solar radiation coming through all those little holes you've made into space. So overall, unless we find another suitable location where human life can flourish, then I don't think it's going anywhere anytime soon. Which sucks because this would mean no one else can ever visit us here either. Money is a problem for space colonization. In order to colonize space, you need money, and lots of it. It's hard to get into space, but once you're there, the costs are high, and will only go up as time goes on. The cost of getting into space is a big hurdle for anyone who wants to colonize Mars or another planet. The amount that it costs for each launch varies based on what kind of vehicle is used and how many people are going aboard the ship. But let's take an average figure of $20 billion per launch, and say that one person makes a trip per year over 50 years at this rate. Then we would have spent $1 trillion just getting into outer space. And once you're there? Well, it gets pretty expensive too. Just think about all those things that come with being in outer space. Food, water filtration systems, oxygen generators, all that stuff adds up quickly when you're living hundreds or thousands of miles away from Earth's resources. Plus, if any disaster happens while out there, say something breaks down badly enough so your life support system shuts off, then everything becomes much more expensive than before because now we need extra supplies shipped out there ASAP so everyone can stay alive until help arrives from Earth. Which brings us back around again to money. And time delays due where no one wants to risk sending anything without knowing exactly what went wrong first. How about energy generation? The Sun, a nuclear fusion reactor 93 million miles away, is one of the most potent sources of energy in our solar system. But it's not just about solar power, the Moon has plenty of wind and tidal energy, too. The Earth itself is also rich in geothermal potential. If we could tap into all the heat from deep within our planet, we'd have enough to power humanity indefinitely. Hydropower can be harnessed by damming rivers and using turbines to generate electricity. And don't forget nuclear fission. We already know how to produce massive amounts of energy via nuclear reactions. What is made in space? There's a company called Made in Space that makes the stuff we need for space travel. They've made 3D printers and computer chips, but they're also working on a satellite that can make its own parts by pulling raw materials from around itself. And they've done it. The first 3D printed part in space was installed on the International Space Station back in 2014. Climate of space colonies. The environmental and climatic conditions of a colony are important to consider. The optimum temperature range for humans is between 68 and 77 degrees Fahrenheit. If it is too hot or cold, people will become uncomfortable, suffer heat stroke or hypothermia, which can lead to death. One solution would be to use air conditioning or heating systems. However, this could mean that colonists would need to consume more energy than they produce with the solar panels on their space station or moon base. Thus far, there have been no plans for large colonies in space because we don't yet have the technology needed to keep them warm enough for humans' comfort levels during long periods of time. Another consideration is lighting. If a colony's lights are turned off at night when nobody's working, then there won't be any artificial light pollution. However, this means that plants won't grow properly unless they get some natural sunlight every day. Is space colonization possible? Yes, but it will take many years. Space colonization is a long-term goal. It will take many years to get there, and we have many challenges to overcome before we can even begin thinking about making it reality. We cannot just go to Mars and expect things to be easy for us. The environment on Mars is very harsh and dangerous, so it would be impossible for humans to live there without being prepared for that environment. We need to understand what it's like on other planets in order for us as humans who want space colonization, especially with this project being such an ambitious one. There are also many other factors involved with space colonization, such as how much money we're willing to invest into this project as well as how much time do we actually have left. Final thoughts. So, is space colonization possible? Like I just stated, yes, but it will take many years. We have to use our resources wisely and we need to invest in new technologies that can help us colonize other planets in the solar system. This means we also need to work together as humans because only when everyone thinks about the future together can we make our dreams come true. Thanks for watching and be sure to check out these related videos you may enjoy.